Andrew has asked, does the air fuel ratio under load change between different engines? If so, what's the best way to find the best air fuel ratio for each car? It's a really good question, Andrew, and the answer is yes, it does. And this is something that most professional tuners tend to completely ignore. What we find is that most professional tuners out there in the industry just approach every engine with exactly the same air fuel ratio target. They tune it to achieve that target and then they send it out the door. Now, that's not to say that there's necessarily anything wrong with that. It doesn't mean that the engines are going to blow up, but it may mean that we're leaving a little bit of potential power and torque on the table. To explain this, let me give you a quick example. Let's say we've got a tuner who specializes in tuning Honda B-series engines, maybe a Honda B18C naturally aspirated engines. Find that with that particular engine, it's actually going to perform really well and make great power and torque and be really reliable if we tune around about 13.2 to 1 air fuel ratio under wide open throttle. So let's say that tuner who's really experienced with the Honda B-Series all of a sudden gets a stock standard GM 6-liter LS2 come through the door. So of course, they apply what they know works on the Honda B-Series engine. And what they're going to find is that, well, yes, we can make that LS2 run at an air fuel ratio of 13.2 to 1, and no, it's not going to necessarily be damaged. What we're going to find is that, particularly at higher RPM, the engine is going to become very prone to detonation. In order to stop that, the tuner is going to then need to retard the ignition timing. And as a result, we're going to end up reducing our power and torque. Now, if on the other hand, instead of blindly applying a fixed air fuel ratio, the tuner had tested to see what the engine actually wanted, we would find that if we richened the air fuel ratio at higher RPM down to perhaps around about 12.5, 12.6 to 1, the cooler combustion charge temperature that as a result of that richer air fuel ratio means that we can actually add a few degrees more timing. The net result is with the richer air fuel ratio, we're actually going to end up with more power and torque. So it's always important to test on the dyno and actually find what your particular engine wants and what it responds to. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.